Now there's one thing that I always do, and that's painting feathers in layers. This gives a bird a more realistic feel, more of a three-dimensional shape, and a feeling of fullness and depth to that plumage. In this video, I'm going to share how I prepare to apply the final layer of pale feathers. You'll be surprised to see that I'm actually going dark with the detail. By doing this, I create varied tones, which will later show through those paler feathers, and it will give the bird shape and form.
I'm just working on this tree sparrow, and you can see I'm just thinking about adding the first layer of detail for this chest, okay? All the base you've done, just to give us some heads up on this, just while I say hello to you, is with a wet and wet wash of a variety of colours, working with raw umber, burnt umber, what we use, French ultramarine, lamp black, a little bit of Payne's grey, even gambo hues for its little bottom there, gambo hue and a little bit of burnt umber. And they were the kind of wet in wet washes first of all, which I've applied and then dried. And using my replicator brush, my homemade brush, I've got a video on this, I'll put a link to the top right hand corner for you. I've been using that one to apply the first layer of detail over the top, as you can see. And that's how I'm kind of building this up gradually by overlapping these lines. I'm actually looking at the direction of the lines as well while I'm doing this. You see that from the reference photograph, which I've just popped into the corner just briefly there for you. You see what I mean there, though? So the lines tend to overlap. And when you look at the chest feathers on a bird as well, and the, down to the belly and the bottom, the little bottom down there, then you can see the way they sort of go sideways. Well, a piece of paper for you. I'll show you what I mean, though. Let's get some more paint, okay? So when they're working the way around, they're not all in line with one another like that. They'll overlap. So it's going to be two lines and overlapping like so. And that's the way I tend to work on this chest all the way around. So now, after using my replicator brush, I'm going to go back to my size 00, which is this one here. And I need to thicken this paint down. So if I had to get a little bit more paint in there, so lamp black. Okay. Normally I would do this with my old mixing brush, not my new brush, because you can ruin your brushes very quickly doing it this way around. A little bit of lamp black and some burnt umber. Some more. A little tip as well, don't do this over the top of your painting, okay? Because if you do, you're going to start dropping blobs of water and paint all over your artwork. And you won't be very happy. I know I wouldn't be. So now what I want to do is start to add in some darker lines where these white feathers go here, because I'm going to be using watercolor white over the top of this, as I've already done for the wing feathers, as you can see here. So I want to randomize these marks just so they overlap and crisscross in places as well, because we need the dark color underneath so we can add the white over the top. Otherwise the white won't stand out, will it? Can't have one without the other. You need dark and light. And that's going to work its way down there, varying the direction of the lines, varying the length of the lines at the same time. And I'm going to make sure that when I get around to this side of the chest now, the lines are going to get shorter. And also, slightly curved in places, varying the angle, and they suddenly start to disappear like that, look, right up towards the main neck of the bird. Okay. Gradually increasing the lines to work my way down the chest. A few more around there. Also look at the way that these tend to have little blocks as well. So for example, you've got a little block here. Just to show you what I mean there, that. Little block there. And then you leave that and then you do another little block. Like so. And eventually what will happen is you'll end up with kind of very, I don't know, small blocks all the way over the chest. But they blend together quite well. There's another block, and so on all the way down the chest. But I noticed as well when I looked at the reference photograph, because you've really got to scan it carefully, haven't you, before you make a start on anything like this. The way that you know, these lines vary. So when you get down towards underneath here, you can just see them varying a little bit, and they start to go more downhill. What I akin this to is a clock face. So when you look at a clock, you look at the direction of the hands. For example, this way here is going to be going more towards 8 o'clock, down that way there. and then you kind of turn it uphill a little bit more towards 9 o'clock and then 10 o'clock and so on. So that's how I tend to look at the directions, and that's how I tend to paint, just to ensure that the brush directions give you a much more 3D shape as well. Okay, just a few more down here now. Tell you what I'm going to do actually, I'm going to get some more of my gambo hue and the burnt umber and pop that down there. I need a little more of a kind of more of a hint down there of colour. I have a feeling this could be reflective lights down here as well. So I've done the same on the bottom, probably a little bit more on the bottom actually saying that. Don't want it too bright, whilst it'll have a yellow bum. We don't want that really, do we? So once that's dry, I can then start to add some details over the top of that. And I still want all this detail to show through and add the white over the top. Okay, right, so let's just carry on and add a bit more now underneath this wing. Now the wing itself, I'm going to wing it, the wing itself is quite dark underneath there, isn't it? I've got to be careful because I don't want to put too much paint on the actual wing, so I've got to be careful not to touch that wing while I do this. Now this is all wet down there now, so we'll end up blending that dark colour in there, which is fine. See, that's better. See, now that looks like the wing, so that's it, sat over the top of the bottom of the bird there. Just by very carefully using my sized Ordero brush, adding those details underneath that wing and looking at the direction of the feathers as well, the way that they go then. You can see that they go more towards the 4 o'clock direction, don't they? You know that now. Then bring a few just over the back of the bird, as you can see here, into this now damp paper, flicking around, and I'll do the same on the side here now. Right, so now you can see I've built this up quite well, haven't I? So it's a lot of detail on there. That's all ready to receive the white paint in a minute over the top. So I want this chest to stand out. But you've got to remember that when you look at the chest itself, it's not white all over, is it? You've got white, yeah, of course you have. But there's a lot of dark in there as well. And I want some of that dark to show through. And then down towards there as well. Okay. And I think we're about there and ready for the white paint. Yeah. Now check out the video to the top right and I'll show you how I go on to apply the pale top feathers on another bird that I enjoy painting.